always serving a fresh cup of daily inspiration, Dianna Hobbs.
Today's inspiration is to let you know that God is changing your season. You are about to go through a good transition in your life. God has got an incredible plan to lift you up out of this horrible pit and set you up in a good place for His glory. Welcome to this, your Friday, April 20th, 2018 edition of your Daily Cup of Inspiration podcast. My name is Dianna Hobbs, founder of Empowering Everyday Women Ministries, a 501c3 nonprofit organization that distributes free resources all around the world to help you grow in your faith and become everything God has destined you to be. I am broadcasting live from Empowering Everyday Women Ministry Studios in the city of Buffalo, New York. It is currently 30 degrees in the Queen City. And so, Daily Cup family, I need you to, wherever you are, go ahead and stretch your hand toward this device and say, "Warmth for Buffalo, Jesus." Speak over us. It is still cold. It feels like winter. We are all bundled up. However, I am still excited. God brought us through another week. Can you believe it's Friday again? Thanks for hanging out with me all week long and allowing me to deposit seeds of inspiration into your heart. I just love you. We are a strong faith community globally, spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ. What a blessing to be connected to something like this for the kingdom of God. Amen. Every single podcast you hear, it is available for you as an absolutely free resource. Go ahead and stream it, download it, share it. It's on iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher.com, yourdailycupofinspiration.com, player.fm, on my YouTube channel under my name, Dianna Hobbs, D-I-A-N-N-A-H-O-B-B-S. Easily click that red subscribe button, turn on your notifications, and every time a podcast is uploaded, you'll be among the first to know. I am ready to receive this Friday word. Let's begin with a prayer. God, our Father, we love you so much. Thank you for bringing us through another week. I pray for this individual that has pressed play. You sent them here, so there's a word for them. Help them to open up their hearts to receive all that you will say, and it will enrich them and give them strength and peace and joy and empowerment to do everything they're called to do. In Jesus' name, amen. As a ministry leader, I connect to people all over the world, and I hear many heartbreaking stories where life just happens. Yesterday, on my blog at yourdailycupofinspiration.com, I posted some of the prayer requests that individuals asked to have posted on the blog for our Thoughtful Thursday's intercessory prayer post. Thank you for those who read and prayed. If you haven't, it's not too late. Make your way over there. But one of the prayer requests is from a woman who asked to remain anonymous but wanted her request shared. And this is part of what she wrote. "At this moment, I have been living in my car. I've been through a lot, domestic violence, everything stolen from me, and a horrible divorce. I daily ask God by faith to completely deliver me from lack, bondage, homelessness, debt, loneliness, and depression." That's a portion of our request, Daily Cup family, and I believe God is going to completely restore her. My prayer team and I touched and agreed. She's holding on to faith in difficult circumstances. One of my favorite verses in the Bible that perfectly describes the way life goes is found in Ecclesiastes 9:11. This scripture in the New International Version says, "I have seen something else under the sun. The race is not to the swift, or the battle to the strong, nor does food come to the wise, or wealth to the brilliant, or favor to the learned, but time and chance happen to them all." That just means we face certain negative outcomes that we can't control. As much as we would like to determine how things turn out, we don't get to do that. We can't manipulate time and we can't manipulate outcomes. Time and chance happens to us all. And that would be some discouraging truth for somebody. Somebody might say, "Well, it doesn't matter what I do. I can't get ahead. Negative stuff always happens to me and I can't control it, so I may as well give up." Absolutely not. Even though time and chance happens to us all power still belongs to our God. Even though life happens, God also happens. That means when He shows up, He's able to change the course of your destiny. You are not at the mercy of time and chance. You are in the hands of the one who has power over time and chance. Realizing that God is in control will give you peace in situations where you feel out of control. In the early church, though, believers had trouble with with the concept of not being in control, which is why the Apostle Paul had to get the church at Galatia together. In Galatians 5:1, he wrote, "Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ hath made us free, and be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage." In this scriptural passage, Paul was telling believers not to be yoked to, burdened by, or tied to the law of circumcision, which based salvation on human achievement as a sign of the covenant that God established with Abraham in Genesis chapter 17. They thought, if I do this and obey the Old Testament laws established under Moses, known as the Mosaic Law, I'll be accepted by God. But after Jesus Christ came, this was no longer necessary. Jesus died and rose to take away sin. We are cleansed and made righteous through his blood. They had a legalistic mindset. They thought they had to keep laws to gain acceptance. Sometimes we make the same error in life. We have a very works-based, secular philosophy on success, achievement, and the way to be blessed. Many believe that we reap favor and blessings, rewards, and benefits because of good behavior, as if any of us could earn God's love and favor. God's favor is a result of righteousness, that's true, but not our righteousness. Isaiah 64:6 teaches us that our righteous acts are like filthy rags to God, and he blesses whoever he pleases. He has chosen to bless you because he loves you, because he delights in you. Even if time and chance happened to you and left you in a pit, in a hole, in debt, in despair, in trouble, in crisis, it is not your power, intellect, connections, your hustle, your grind, your perfection that makes things happen and shifts circumstances for the better. It is God. It is not works. It is a gift. He's going to bless you. He's changing your season. He's giving you supernatural benefits by his power alone. I don't know what you've been through or what you're currently going through, but you must know that God's blessings being upon you have nothing to do with your qualifications. It is his divine favor. It is God who changes seasons, opens doors, makes ways, and empowers you to do whatever he's commanded you to do. In Deuteronomy 8, remember when God told his people Israel that he allowed them to wander in the wilderness for all that time so they wouldn't think they were the ones that made things fall into place in their lives? In verse 17, the Lord said, "I let you struggle. Otherwise, you may say in your heart, 'My power and the strength of my hand made me this well.'" God even let Paul suffer with an affliction so that this anointed man of God would know that God's grace was sufficient for him, that God's power was made perfect in his weakness. That's in 2 Corinthians 12:1-10. The Lord let you endure hardship, knock on doors that didn't open, and do all you could only to watch it seemingly remain stagnant for a purpose. Throughout the process, through tears and sometimes aggravation, he was teaching you that it's not you that opens doors and makes ways. It is him. He has allowed the storm so you would get rid of that independent mentality and develop a God-dependent mindset. Listen, the trials that time and chance produced in your life are nothing more than opportunities for God to display the truth of Psalm 34:19, which says, "Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all." He has power over difficulties, challenges, and troubles. Time and chance must even be subject to his authority. There are things you are believing God to do. He's going to do them. Everything in your life is changing. You're transitioning out of this wilderness and into promise by his power. To confirm this word, I'm stirring the first 5 words of Daniel 2:21 in the New International Version right into your cup of inspiration. And it simply says, "He changes times and seasons." As you drink down the contents of your cup, know that God, who changes times and seasons, is changing your season. He has the last say. He is the final authority. And when God says enough, everything must shift. Every storm must cease. Every issue must resolve. Every disease must vanish. Every knee must bow and every tongue confess that he is Lord. It is not your power, wisdom, resources, education, experience, organizational abilities, goal setting, or your drive that will unlock the treasure trove of blessings preordained for your season. It is his grace, his love, His favor, His wisdom, His might, His purpose, His power, and His sovereignty that are producing the amazing results you're about to see manifest in your life. Zechariah 4 and 6 in the New International Version reminds you that your season is changing not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord Almighty. Now let's pray. God, I pray for this, my sister, this, my brother. Thank you that you are changing their season. They have been struggling, but you are bringing them into a place of blessing, favor, peace, and rest. All power belongs to you, O God. Give them strength to stand, faith to believe, and the resolve to trust you through whatever. Thank you in advance for the manifestation of the breakthrough you have already secured for them. In Jesus' name, we glorify your name. Amen.
Your Daily Cup of Inspiration podcast has been brought to you by Empowering Everyday Women Ministries, where we help fuel your faith every day. For more information, log on to www.deannahobbs.com.